What's up, y'all? It's iFigle, Flowtox. Yet another episode. But you know what? It's been like a year and a half since I've made a video. It's been a long time, seemingly. I feel like a lot's changed with me, at least internally. And yeah, it's June of 2022. Probably the last video I made was like January of 2021, February 2021. Sort of moving through this last year of COVID, relaxed restrictions, but this past year I've struggled a lot. Anxiety and depression, and really I've been trying to do work on ways to improve my self-worth and realize my worth, realize my value, realize my incompetencies, supposed, and some other things that I might not want to feel. But after so many years of not feeling them and ignoring them, some of these feelings have grown to be too big to ignore. So dealing with a lot of my insecurities, my childhood, and how my childhood and everything else in my life has affected me, and trying to look at all that honestly. And not all of it's beautiful and bright and shiny, a lot of it isn't. We like to pretend that everything's fine, that there's nothing to worry about, that we're healthy, that we know what we want. But a lot of times, I feel like we're not brave enough to actually look at those things. Some guys, they got the life ring out here in the Chicago River. Montrose Ave. Interesting. So, but we don't need to just look at the bad and realize our flaws and go into the darkness and stay there. It's our point. It should be the point to illuminate those areas and not keep them dark, but lighten them. Look at your anger, look at your hurt, to look at your pain, your insecurities, what you think your inadequacies are. All of those we should look at those, but not look at them with a critical eye or the judgment, but with compassion, and realize that the hurt is okay. And it's okay to be hurt. And it's okay to empathize with that hurt. And tell that part of you that it's okay. It's a lot of the difficulty I've had in the past few years. I quit smoking cigarettes, quit nicotine, and since then, the struggle for my mental well-being has been real. Trying to overcome those addictive urges, those addictive parts of me that are a part of me, but they're not all of me. And realize that the things I use my addictions for, they're a part of me as well. And they don't have to be told, oh, that's not right. You're not right for thinking that way or feeling that way. They need to be approached in a way where you say, that's understandable. I understand why you hurt. I understand why you feel anxious. It's okay to feel anxious. And then when you address it in such a way, with compassion, with love, you don't have to pathologize it as bad, to critique it, to judge it on a polar spectrum, but let it be, and just let it be as a part of your existence, of who you are. We're taught that we aren't good enough, that if we don't have certain things, we haven't tried hard enough, and it's a personal failure. The whole American dream bootstrap theory. Despite how much we want to think we're an island and that we're in control of our situation, a lot of things are determined for us. And a lot of things are out of our control. We have to realize what we can do to get to where we want. And what we can't do. And how those things that we can't do, yeah, maybe they prevent us from getting to where we want to be. But we have to leave those behind. Almost as if all the possibilities, the infiniteness of the universe as you go outward exists. As you leave all of those deterministic and systemic institutions, when you leave those behind in search of yourself, in search of your desires, the possibilities are almost as infinite. There are no bounds. Your light can reach as far as the light of the sun I'm basking in right now. So, we need to understand we are an island in as much as that we have subjective feelings, subjective experiences, interpretations, and thoughts. But we are also victims of an objective reality that has placed us here. So we need to use our subjectivity to maneuver and map our way through what has been given to us. And to try to force it and strive for it obsessively and to go for perfection all the time is not it's not attainable, and it's unrealistic. We are limited and free. and allow yourself to live in compassion and love, realizing that what you feel and the things you might feel as bad might not actually be bad. And if you look at them and you care for them and you love them and you sit with it and hold a bad feeling or a bad thought, and just to let it be and let it go, that will allow you to move on away from resentment or anger or anything like that. Anyways, it's good to be back. It's good to do some Flow Talks. This is I Feigl here on Flow Talks, running around north side of Chicago here in Horner Park. Try to do this again soon. Try to have more things I want to talk about. Peace and love. Baby, baby. Miss you so much.